Hi, this is Shubham from Moonistu, and today in this podcast we're gonna discuss about hedge funds. What are these hedge funds, what they do, how their valuation done, different characteristics of that, how you should invest in, what are the different types and so on. Over here in this podcast we're gonna discuss everything from scratch about hedge funds and the working of hedge funds in India. So let's discuss. First we start with the hedge funds. Hedge funds are actively managed alternative investments that use non-traditional asset classes or investment strategy. Hedge funds are traded in a fixed income securities, convertible securities, currency, exchange traded futures, over-the-counter derivative, future contract, commodity, options, and non-security assets. So all in all, hedge funds include all different classes of assets which are traded in stock market. The basics is the more huge amount of money is involved through institutional or non-institutional investor. So what is basically the hedge funds are? Hedge funds are unregistered private investment joint venture fund or pool that invest and trade across the board of variety of markets, technique and instrument. They are not subject to the same regulatory requirement as a mutual fund, such as providing investor with a certain standardized pricing and valuation information regularly. Furthermore, hedge funds employ a combination of strategies like hedging and arbitrage method to achieve their goal of investment return. Being high value and being high risky investments, hedge funds generally target high net worth individual and institutional for their clients. Let's understand valuation and management of hedge funds. A hedge fund invests money from approved investor, including insurance company, bank, wealthy family, as well as endowment pension funds. These funds required operate at a high level of skill. Frequently, these are operated as a foreign investment corporation or private investment partnership. They don't have to register with SEBI in India, and they don't have to report a NAV regularly like a mutual fund. Assets type such as derivative stock, bond, currency, convertible security make up hedge fund's portfolio. As a result, they sometimes refer to as an alternative investment. They require active management of a grouping of assets with aim to hedge risk, to invest money against markets ups and down. Unlike other stock or mutual fund, hedge funds tend to use lot of leverage. They invest in both long as well as short position, also in listed as well as unlisted market, including startups. Let's understand the characteristic of hedge funds. First, hedge funds are structured as a private investment partnership or offshore investment corporation. Second, they employ a wide range of a trading strategy involving position taking in a variety of markets. Third, they may prefer performance fees for their managers. Fourth, the target is a rich individual and institutional investor and have a relatively high minimum investment limit. So who should invest in hedge funds? Hedge funds are like a mutual fund that are managed by a professional privately. As a result, they are usually little more pricey because the management buy and sell asset at a drizzling speed and keep up with the market changes. You must not only have extra cash but also an aggressive risk taker. As you may be aware, the more structural complexity there is, the greater the hazards. Therefore, hedge funds have a much higher expense ratio than regular mutual fund. First time depository may do not well to stay away from this fund, and unless they have a sizable corpus and the risk appetite to do so. Let's understand different types of hedge fund. The first one is a domestic hedge fund. As the name suggests, domestic hedge funds are only available to investors who are taxed in the nation of origin. Second one is an offshore hedge fund. Offshore hedge funds are funds that are created outside your home nation, preferably low tax jurisdiction. Third one is a fund of funds. These are mutual funds that invest in other funds beyond the geographical border, a type of mutual fund that pools money and employ one or two sub manager to invest in a stock, commodity, currency. Investor allocate assets to fund of fund for the variety of reason, including delivery across manager, risk type, risk exposure, etc. Hedge fund can also be differentiated on the basis of their investing strategy, such as event driven fund invest in assets of a portion for those classes where gonna affect with the event. Merger and arbitrage funds also there. The fourth ones are global macro fund. These are hedge funds that take a long and short position in major financial market. The fifth and last one is a market neutral fund. These are those in which the management try to keep market risk as minimum or low. Long short-term equity funds, convertible bond arbitrage fund and fixed income arbitrage are also included in this category. Let's understand the trading psychology behind this. A hedge fund is a regulated investment fund that is generally only accessible to a selected group of high value investor, high net worth individual and firm. Every hedge fund has its investment philosophy, which influences the kind of investment made and technique used. Hedge funds are generally engaged in a far broader variety of investing and trading trading activities than typical long only investment fund, mutual fund or AMC etc. Hedge fund engage in diversified variety of assets including long and short stock, bond, commodity, derivative options. So here basically the psychology is trade as much as you can in a different variety of classes to minimize the risk, maximize the return, but since we are dealing privately the risk is high. Let's understand risk and return of a hedge fund. The fact that the regulatory standard being relaxed, so the about the product is gonna be really high risky. Apart from the fact that there is an underlying security in which a top hedge fund invests in a similar high risk, the product is not legally required to register with SEBI or disclose its NAV regularly. These two elements ensure that the rest of our money is closely monitored and regulated. This does not imply that SEBI leave the money unregulated, but the lack of legal obligation raises the risk for a threshold. Risk and reward are exactly proportionate. As we all know, hedge fund returns like their risk are on the upper end of the spectrum. Let's understand what are the different benefits of investing in a hedge fund. Investing in hedge funds have several advantages including alignment of interests between investor and fund manager, flexibility, aggressive investment approach. Hedge funds are set up in such a manner that the fund manager and investor interested in align, including features such as high watermark. High performance leads to higher increase in management fees and commission and bonuses. Therefore, generally hedge funds tend to get a more return. Hedge fund industry is basically based on the performance industry. Hence, the performance of hedge fund overall has to be good and normally beat the index. Hedge funds utilize short-term trading method to take advantage of a perceived security mispricing. Because security markets are in dynamic, market price may give a variety of prices range from rational to irrational. So the basic objective is to take the market entry at a irrational price, and when the markets are rational, get the returns and knock off the price. Hedge funds are effectively implemented and manage alternative investment that use a non-directional asset class or investment strategy. Hedge funds provide high risk but provide a good return as well. So let's discuss what is the bottom line over here. In India, hedge funds are not that typically popular because of concentrated of less number of people interested in investing, but the mere objective is to get the more institutional and rich individual and family as a client to improve the risk reward relationship over here. In India, hedge funds industry is a performance driven where the maximum performance will fetch a maximum return for both investors as well as management in terms of a return or profit and in terms of a management fees. So thank you guys for listening with us. Here Shubham from Moon is signing off. But before that, if you want to read the full article, then the link of article provided is in the description. Thank you.